it's really, really awesome. I'm so glad you're here. Thank you for stopping by with
Thank
us.
You.
And Lipbone Redding.
Where was it? Oh, the kitchen. I was in the kitchen, yeah. I had these spatulas strapped to my feet one day, and I thought, oh, what's going on over here? Are you okay? All right, all right, because you're part of the show now. You simmer down over there. It's your first time? So I switched to the power of the wooden spoon. So when I was a kid, I went to a high school in Hollywood, North Carolina, Hollywood Crossroads, and I had this beautiful girlfriend at the time. She was a cheerleader, and I knew right away I needed to get somehow. I wasn't going to get on the football team, but I needed to get on the cheerleading squad. So I went one day and I proposed that, you know what this school needs is a school mascot, the Mighty Viking. So I went home and I put together like a blonde wig and a pointy hat kind of a thing and a skirt, male skirt, kilt, I think they call it. Some sandals and a sword. And I came back and I said, here's the Mighty Viking. Go Mighty Vikings. And they said, you're hired. And so from that day, through all of my high school days, when the players would come off the field all covered in blood and sweat and grass stains, I'd jump in the back of the van with the cheerleaders and say, see you later, fellas. Have a good trip back to town. And so there was this one girl. She wanted to come to Hollywood, California, be a movie star. So I said, you know what? I tell you what, I'll go out there and visit you one day. But I never made it. I went to New York instead. But I wrote her a song. And being in California, I thought, well, maybe I'll play this song tonight. Hollywood and vibe. Today they say the human race can put a man in outer space. How come no one died with this alone? Something wrong. Can't see me putting my finger on. I look in your eyes and get a little tingle down my spine. I'm so related, I believe I'm inseparable from the divine. Oh, my got that feeling. Everything might just work out. My own time. Hollywood, see me in Hollywood. I dig New York in spring and green, the things for which we care. Last time I saw you, baby, had a diamond in your teeth. With the satin underwear, they're shaking it everywhere. With you, I'm unstoppable, my heart is full. Loves every pore of my song is always on your radio. Turn it up, turn it loose, get wild, baby, turn the juice. I've got that feeling, oh, I got that feeling. It's gonna just work on out like Hollywood. Fast cars and movie stars. Get out of my lane of traffic. That's what I said. What's that? Stop beeping at me. Thank you. Hollywood, Hollywood and Vine.
It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you very much. My guitar is still becoming adjusted to this weirdly humid yet dry climate. So, here we go. So I promised I was going to play a different set, and I know than I normally do. And I know since we're live streaming. I'm going to be taking requests from some of my fans out there, so I hope you guys don't mind. It was supposed to be a private cream of the crop, you know, the cream floats at the top type of event, but we've got a bunch of riffraff out there who are listening right now. So please, riffraff friends of mine, just tell me what you'd like to hear. And Karen over here will call it out because she's monitoring you right now. She is the monitor of the event tonight. So this is really very exciting, the fact that we're all kind of here together. In the meantime, I'd like to tell you a little story. I'll kind of do a roundabout about this story because I spent a lot of time in New York City. I was a subway musician for about 3 long years. I'll get to that later. But there came a time when I had to get out of New York, and I said, you know what, I need a vehicle. I need a tour vehicle. And not only that, I need to go all the way down to the Mardi Gras in New Orleans. And this sound right here, that happened to be the sound of my 1984 Nissan pickup truck. Sitting in traffic. And a little faster on the New Jersey Turnpike. There I went, all the way down to New Orleans. Stopped in North Carolina to see my mom. I said, hi, Mom. She said, hi, son. Hi, Mom. I know she's watching tonight. Got to Atlanta, Georgia. Stood in traffic. It's almost like L.A. in Atlanta, Georgia. Went there. And then I almost got to Mardi Gras down in New Orleans. You know what happened? I heard this sound. And I rolled off the freeway. Oh, had just enough juice to get up the hump and up over and into the first parking lot I came to, which happened to be the parking lot of the Tantastic Sun Tanning Salon of Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Oh, man. There was a party going on in the parking lot. The volunteer fire department was there. It was like my lucky day, man. There was it smelled like roasting chickens. I mean, it was like a really exciting thing happening. And then I realized, oh, my God, I'm completely wrong. There's two girls trapped in a suntan booth together, and they're covered in coconut oil, and they're trying to get them out. So I said, man, this is gonna make a great Mardi Gras song. Use it, man, use it, song. So I'm gonna use my experience, but I'm gonna need you guys to help me just a little bit. So when I go, those golden ladies.
Those golden ladies.
Those golden ladies. In the downtown sun tan booth with a friend to be the queen of Polynesia. But that woman in there I never knew. Some call the doctors, the lawyers, the firemen to see anything that they could do. Those men of Highland, they just shook their heads and Lord, two chicks are burning in sun tan booth.
Those golden ladies.
Don't worry, y'all. Everybody survived. It was all good. Everything was good in the end.
they called the junior high school teacher. Anybody and everybody sing anything that could be done. They tried to bust the door down, everybody just got drunk and woo, tore the store down. Any other night in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, they call that fun. Some about to find a combination. They called up the local TV station. The camera was rolling and they opened up that smoking sundae. The both front to a grill, cried the reporter with a list. And the fountain looked like an old shriveled up broom. Woo! Those golden ladies.
Those golden ladies.
Woo! Oh, something smelled like Southern barbecue. Machine Mark One that I had, the very first one, the Nissan pickup truck, 1984, and the second one that I had was this beautiful hippie van. You would have loved it, you know, since you guys are at the beach and everything. It had like a step van with the Lord Shiva painted on the side, and like rays of light coming out of his eyes, and purple turtles and green hyperspace all over it with triangles and stuff floating around. It was beautiful, man. It was like, wow, boom. And there, I drove that thing everywhere, man. In every single parking lot and small town I went to, the people were like, "What's in there?" And the cops were like, "What's in there?" I get a little old after a while, actually. So I decided I was gonna go stealth mode one year, and I got me a soccer mom van. Yeah, Grand Caravan, Stow and Go, the whole bit. Had the sticker family on the back, the stick family on the back, and a dinosaur chasing them, just. Good luck, and even another sticker on the other side with a my kid's an honor student somewhere. I don't know. Are you an honor student? Okay. Well, I'd like to meet you because you'd be the only one, I think. So, thanks for being here. I appreciate it. I don't mean to insult you. Anyway, I drove all over, man. I went to all the green states that year. Green states like Colorado. California, and all those, obviously, where's the guy with the Grateful Dead shirt on, where are you? Oh, he left already, he's out there playing Pokemon right now. Anyway, so I went to all the green states, and man, I was so happy. People are so happy in the green states when it comes to music. Yeah, they're so relaxed. you know, something in the air, maybe, I don't know what it is. And that siren right there actually fits in perfectly. It gives me PTSD a little bit, because there I was coming over Vail Pass in Colorado and down and then up again over Loveland Pass and down towards Denver and down. It's all downhill from there once you get to Denver. Down, headed back east, and then the next thing you know, I'm in Kansas. Mm. You know what they're doing in Kansas right now? They're getting ready. That's what the cops are doing, at least. They're getting ready. They're waiting for you. Coming over there, feeling all happy from the green state into that whatever color state that is. And then you get there, and they're waiting, I swear, and they saw me with a smile on my face. And that siren sound, like a, you know, whining, moaning wolf cry, you know. Oh my God, I turned around, and they pulled me over, and they went through all my stuff, even my toothpaste, you know, looking for whatever, that happy stuff, whatever makes you happy in the green states. And I didn't happen to have any that they could find. And they didn't find anything. And yet at one point they called in and they said, "Stop, I don't know what to do." You know, and then they gave me a ticket for $487.26. I know. I was like, "God, what am I supposed to do with this?" He said, "Well, you got to pay it." And he said, "You need to pay at the courthouse or stick around or mail it in." I said, "I'll just mail it in and I'll write a song about Goodland, Kansas and play it every time I go out on the road." So as every chance I get. So here's a song called "The Law in Kansas," and it goes like this. I gotta say this one more thing. You know, on this ticket, there was a lot of vehicular crimes, heinous vehicular crimes you could commit in the state of Kansas. And you know the one I committed? After the long list, nothing was checked at the bottom. It said, "Other." I just had to say that because it made me so mad. I knew I'm another. That's right. I've always known I'm another. It's okay. Timothy Leary said, "Find the other." Oh, yeah. Try to get in the green state vibe here. Whoa. Well, to the East Coast from Colorado Springs. Driving across the Beagle Prairie. I put adjust in my stereo. It's been 80 days with the Lipbone Show. The trouble with trouble, it always find us. Is that the flashing of blue light behind us? Officer, I'm not in a rush. I'm just cruising right along in my Lipbone bus. Officer, I did not see that sign. I didn't even know that I'd crossed the state line. And do your state of nervousness and fear. Please take your hand off your weapon, sir. I'm not from around here. No, just a musician on the road. Holy, holy mission. Just a musician, and I don't need trouble. The law in Kansas. Out here on the road, I live like Robinson Crusoe. Fulfill my quest, yes, I intend to do so. My friends and family think I'm glamorous as hell, but I'm staying every night in the parking lot of the Super 8 Motel. Free Wi-Fi. At 1527, we got a hot one here. Yeah, looks like a hippie on the loose to me. What do we do? I don't know. Search through all this stuff. Make sure you check the toothpaste. Nope, there's nothing here. He seems innocent to me. He's not innocent. Just look at him. Well, give him a ticket. Wait. Full body search. No, never mind. He might like that. Remember I was telling you before, I almost got down to New Orleans at that moment. And then I finally made it to New Orleans for the very first time. Oh. You ever been to, anybody not been to New Orleans in here? Anybody? You're going. Oh, yeah, you're going to go. I got a good feeling. I got a really good feeling. It's a very romantic place to go. And, it was for me, at least. I learned my very first French word in New Orleans, as a matter of fact. You know what that word was?
French word.
That might be your first. I wish you all the best. Good luck. Macrame. You know what macrame is? You don't know what macrame? It's this thing that happened in the 70s where they took hemp and they braided it into like potholders and like little plants and stuff like that. They put a big wooden bead on the bottom of it and it was everywhere. That was all the rage. Macrame, it's a thing. It's a French word. Anyway, and she was really into this thing. She said she had learned it at summer camp and then it just took off from there, you know, went wild. She macrame'd me a water bottle. You know, like a good hippie that that she was. Anyway, and I was the only guy in the French Quarter who seemed to have one. I felt really special, you know. And then, I know, it was really sweet. And then she macrame'd me this, I'd never seen anything like it before. It was a sheath, Mata, for the a remote control on the television set, you know, just in case. And then it started to come to a head and kind of came to the end. The day that I came home and there was a hand-drawn portrait of a fellow that looked very similar to me on the refrigerator. And this hand-drawn portrait of the fellow that looked very similar to me was dressed in a full-body hemp macrame onesie. And I said, well, this is... So, I said, maybe time to retire this relationship. You know, it was before Facebook, so, you know, it'd be like, well, you want to change your status at that point, you know what I mean? But she was a crunchy country girl through and through, and I really cared about her, and she was a great macrame-er. And here we go.
Came in the door.
streaming in.
Said, why? Well, you were really lucky to just stop then. And I said, well, you just couldn't go back the next day, you know. But I did, I know, yeah, right? But I did take a long trip after that. I had been playing in the subway and I had this big bucket. It's like a 5-gallon bucket filled with change. And I went down and I went to the travel agent because flights got really cheap at that time, I do recall. And I took this big bucket down and I took it to the travel agent. I said, how far away can I get with this? Or something like that. And she said, we ended up going to Santiago, Chile. I know, it was beautiful. I flew in and there was the Andes Mountains right out the window of the airplane. Wow. And I look out the other side of the plane and there's about, 30 or 40 stray dogs running right alongside the plane. You know the dogs I speak of, like they're not your pedigree. Manhattan Beach dogs that you see running down. They had poodle heads, maybe schnauzer feet, Bichon Frise tails. I don't know. But they, you know, like God's little experiments. They were spare parts all mashed together, running real fast next to the airplane. Followed us all the way to the arrival gate, tails wagging, tongues hanging out. Then turned it once, like somebody blew one of those invisible dog whistles, and they turned it once and ran back and waited for the next jet to come in. Wow, maybe it's not a bad life to be a dog on the street. In Santiago, 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 Santiago. I'm a dog on the streets of Santiago. I once had a home, but now I'm a stray. Times I run alone with my compañeros. Freedom is a struggle, hey. I don't want it any other way. Santiago. 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 Now check this out. Mama was a purebred. She lived the life. She had fences and family. But she was a rich poodle's wife. She fell in love with daddy's one floppy ear. And one night just hopped the fence. That's how I am here. Born in a trailer, spin behind La Moneda. Just known her up since I was a pup. You know, mama said, welcome to your life, kid. Make the most of it. You got nothing to lose, so never give up. Good luck. In Santiago. 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 And you too, that I was a subway musician in New York City for about 3 years. And oh, don't be alarmed, that's just a wooden spoon attached to my foot. Well, it's actually two of them duct taped together. Gorilla tape, really. It's the strong stuff, you know, from the hardware store. But, you know, in lieu of a percussion section, you know, Lipbone Redding and his budget orchestra. So anyway, I was in the subway in New York City, number 6 train uptown side at Spring Street. That was my stop for about 3 years that I played every single night. And I was on a spiritual journey, you know. I told my mom back home in North Carolina, I said, Mom, I'm gonna make it on Broadway. She said, son, no way. I said, yeah, you know, like Frank Sinatra, do it my way. Ended up playing music even in the subway. Singing some of my mom's old disco record collection too, you know. She had Bee Gees, Earth, Wind & Fire, Grandmaster Flash, and various fire. I used to say, this little snippet right here, it's like a jungle sometimes. Like a jungle. It's like a jungle sometimes that made me wonder. Bong bong, stand clear of the closing doors, please. Oh, you never heard that song? You never heard that sound? If you've ever been in the subway, you heard this sound. Bong bong, stand clear of the closing doors, please. Bong bong. Mark, I know you've heard that sound before. Greenville, North Carolina, to Rocky Mountain. Now I hop the old Amtrak train. I had sky high hope. I had open eyes scope. I had earth all over my face, yo. I said, Mama, I got to go to New York City. The greatest place to be, let's go out of your head. Look what happened to you. Mama's baby, 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 baby. Child. Bong, bong. Stand clear of the closing doors, please. Well, the new wheels on. Time wears on and on. Mama, my roots are showing through. That's how they do. Cares about where you come from, neither. It's all about what they gonna get out of you. That's what they do up there. Up in New York City, the greatest place to be. Left yo, out of your head. Country style. Running wild. Look what happened to you. Mama's baby, 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 baby. Child. Stand clear of closing doors, please. There I was standing on the number 6 train uptown side of Spring Street every night. That's the sound of the train makes coming through the track. It's a noisy track. And then, well, maybe I might have been under the influence of some sort of mind altering substances at the time. However, I was on a spiritual journey, I will tell you that. A deeply spiritual journey. I was looking for my spirit guide. And you know, I thought, well, maybe he'll come, or she'll come in the form of a grizzly bear or something. No grizzly bears ever arrived in the subway when I was playing in New York City. No jaguars or eagles or any of those other fashionable spirit guides ever showed up. No. But one day my very unfashionable spirit guide showed up in the form of, get this, a Mongolian goat herder. I know, it's weird. Whole platform smelled like goats all of a sudden. And I look up and there he is. And he looks at me in the eye and goes, whoa. I said, hey man, how about a little scope? Tic-tac. He said, don't strain yourself, man. I said, oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. You're my spirit guide, aren't you? He said, All right, what would you like me to do first? I said, wait a minute, I can't make that sound, but I'm gonna come back and make another. I put my lips together, I said, about all I got, you know. He said, beep, 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 beep. And I put my lips together and I went, you know, first couple of times is not always the best, they say. But the third time might be the charm. He said, boom, 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 boom. He said, beep, 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 boom, bang. He said, bo, 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 boom, ba, bang. And now, boy, I got down, boom, ba, ba, boom, ba. Mothers clutched their children and ran for the exits. Boom, ba, ba. Apartment. Well, that's what they told me it was. It was a luxury apartment in the Bronx. It was pretty special. It was 12 by 8 feet. And they called it a luxury apartment because it had a veranda. Yeah. It looked just like a fire escape. It was the perfect way. They mocked it up like a fire escape, but they said it was a veranda. It sounded sexier, and they could say luxury apartment that way. And so I said, you know, yeah, let me check it out. So I moved in there, and it was really nice. And talk about a view, you know, if you needed a view. Wait, do you guys all need a break? Do you want a break to go to the bathroom or, you know, like flirt with each other or anything like that? Should I keep going? I mean, I will. I mean, I'm here for, you know, I just need to know. Okay. I'll just go on is what I'm trying to say. I got a million of them. So there, where was I? Oh, in the Bronx, in my luxury apartment. Right. And so it had a view. That was, I think, another reason that it was a luxury apartment. It had a view. And the view was you could stick your head out like this from the veranda. And you could see there's a little crack between the buildings. And you could see two or three stars up there on a very clear night. And then three nights out of the month, the moon would pass over the crack between the buildings for about 13 and a half minutes. And it was very romantic time. And, you know, I would often use that time to play some guitar. There was this beautiful blonde-haired Puerto Rican girl on the fire escape across from me. And then I would look and see it sometimes. And I looked over one night and I said, and I saw her up there on the fire escape. And I said, hola, mamacita. ¿Cómo está? And I'll quote, she said, nuh-uh, no, hell no, you didn't. And anyway, I said, wait, no, come over here and I'll write you a song. And I'll play you a song and I'll put you in it and I'll put me in it. And she, I said, but I've got wine. She said, okay. So she came over and I wrote her this song. and I called it Party on the Veranda. But that didn't work. I renamed it Party on the Fire Escape because that's more accurate. Here we go. Well, the train is rumbling by. Come rolling through the Bronx, heat of the summertime. Fire right in the town on the corner, right in front of Rosario's store. The kids laughing and running through the water, they were raining pouring against the park car. My meatball coming your window, let's have a party on the fire escape. My meatball coming your window, we're gonna have a party on the fire escape. Here we go, Lisa, Lisa, heart of Scott. And we're gonna have a party on the fire escape. Let's have a party on the fire escape. Come New York, we're gonna have a party on the fire escape. Up on the fifth floor, he's in love with that Puerto Rican girl next door. Played a guitar to a cassette tape and was out even on the fire escape. Clears his phone and he knows no shame, and he plugs a few notes in it. He sings out a name, he sings out a name. Here we go, Lisa, Lisa, heart of stars. And we're gonna have a party on the fire escape. Let's have a party on the fire escape. Come to your window, let's have a party on the fire escape. Remember back when life was simple and good. Chilling on the steps of a block of the old neighborhood. Drink your rum and dance until the morning. Music coming, running around the corner. Let's go back there again. Yeah.
Thank y'all very much.
Thank y'all. So listen, here's what we're going to do. We're going to take us a little break, all right? And if you want to come back, please do come back and throw some money and stuff in the bucket. We appreciate that, too. And always, you know, I used to play at this place called Jules Jazz Bistro in New York City, and I would... the band would play, I had a trio, and the band would play, and I'd walk around with a tip bucket. And it was my favorite time of the night, because, well, the money was always good, because it was a good band, you know. But I got to meet everybody, so when I got to talk to everybody, that was always my favorite part. So that's why we're going to take a break, and you guys, you just missed it. Don't worry, it's time to, it's okay. Time to flirt around, and do it, put your arm around, whatever, hold hands, whatever you got to do, get ready, brace yourself, because we'll be back. I'll be back. Yeah. We'll all be back. Okay, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, something like that. Who do you think? Thank you.
Fantastic.
Thank you guys.
Yeah.
Oh, glad you like it. Thank you.
How do you do that?
Is that about the right tempo? Yeah. Did you jump around and throw each other in the air? You guys missed that. Maybe you were here for that. I can't remember. My mother had an extensive disco record collection, and she was a working mom. She had three jobs, mostly two, but then on Tuesday night, she had to go to her third job. for the window installer place where she pick up the telephone and call them and sell storm doors and windows. And she'd drop us off, me and my sister off at my grandparents' house and on Tuesday nights. But Tuesday night was also Tipsy Tuesday at the Moose Lodge in Pitt County, North Carolina. And my grandfather was a loyal, very loyal moose. And on Tuesday nights, it was required that he be there attending the discussion at hand and drink a few beers and discuss some more, further things. And then he'd come home in a jolly mood really late, like about 9 o'clock at night. He'd come up the driveway, you know, and he'd come through the door, and there's my grandmother doing the dishes, and he'd come up behind my grandmother, and he'd put his arms around her, and he'd say, "Beatrice," and he'd give her the moose call. And she'd say, "Oh, John, stop." And he'd say, "Ba-boom." And that was ba-boom. And he'd take her by the hand and he'd lead her away from the sink. Past the Maytag washing machine. Past the General Electric refrigerator. To the center of the kitchen floor and twirl her around and draw her in for a dance. And she resisted at first, but it wasn't long before she'd soften, and like two swans on a placid lake at springtime, they glided together across the linoleum. And he sang her this very song right here.
Girls to sing a song. I'll take a 20 piece
jazz band on my hearse wagon, cause Lipbone Redding's hell as it rolled along.
Spats and wet ground fall.
around. As your speedboat sets sail, the fair Amazonian swan. All blown, and the monkeys all out, and the river birds have all flown. Esmeralda, 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 Esmeralda. In the jungle goes crazy, in the jaguar. And I'm getting dirty looks from the sousaphone.
Love is like an old tattoo. It never fades, although you seem to obscure the scars received in war upon the shores of nevermore. Like an old tattoo, never fades, although you seem to obscure the skies, receive the war on the shores of the moon. Shoes are tied in single knots, the double blue suede jacket, armed with afro. The crease along your summer knitwear slacks, interrupted by the burn of a cigarette, it leaves a scar that you can't forget. Drag like a football through these cotton candy apples, colored circus lights, circus nights, reflecting from your mother's gold medallion. Oh, your friend passed out on the pavement. Oh, the red light district's best attraction, long distance disconnection. Thank you. every moment. I'll be flying home tomorrow. And tomorrow never come, girl. Love is like an old tattoo.
So when I hit the high notes, you know, I've just yanked the hair. So. But thank you guys for coming tonight. I really appreciate it. And thanks, Mark and Karen, for setting this up. And thank you, Michelle, for running the merch table over there. And thank all of you guys for being here. It's been really great. Hope date night works out for you. Ah, it works out for me.
Yeah.
precious. And sure, don't let it slip away, y'all. Gonna love someone. You better love someone. You better love someone. Love someone that will lead. Love someone. Love someone.
Oh, Lord, don't let it love someone, baby.
Love someone. Love someone. So much, and thanks, Mark. Thank you, Manhattan Beach.
Studios.
Oh, wow.
Good times, Joe.